everyone. This time you can watch me make resin ocean beach coasters in a silicon mold in the shape of a scallop. I'm going to add 4 layers of resin, and on some of the layers I'm going to add a resin wave. So I hope you enjoy watching my video and will give me a thumbs up for it. So I already started with the first layer, and the first color that I used was from Color Passion, and it's the Beach Sand Luster. It's an opaque pigment paste. This color that I'm using now is a Bombay ink in the color Aqua, and I also added a little bit of my Sparkle White in it to give it a nice sparkle. And I let those two colors flow into each other. And the next color is another Bombay ink color in the color Blue. And also in this color I added some of the Sparkle White. Also these two colors, the Aqua and the Blue, I will let those colors blend into each other. And I made them very transparent, as you can see. And the silicone molds that I'm using are from Molds and Shapes. So if you're interested in these scallop molds, then the link to their website is in the description below this video. Don't forget my promo code. I have several promo codes, but also for the website of Molds and Shapes, you can find it below this video in the description. Now I'm using my embossing tool to remove air bubbles, but also to blow that beach sand luster a little bit into the aqua color. There you can see it. And then my first layer is already done. So I need to let this dry, and then I will add the second layer. So the resin is dry, now I can add a second layer, and I'm starting with clear resin. This is the line where I want to have my wave. So I always add clear resin. Then a darker shade of blue, again a Bombay ink in a color Blue. But I don't want to cover the whole first layer, only parts of it. And to fill that gap between the clear and the blue, I'm going to use clear resin. So these are very thin layers of resin, and I'm using the resin from Resin Pro. This is the Art Pro resin. It's a medium viscosity resin. You can find the link to their website in the description below this video. And I also have a promo code for this website. Also, the information to that promo code is below this video in the description. There you can see me fill the gap with clear resin. And all the supplies I use in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description below this video. And I always add the link to the website. So if you are curious, check out the description box. There's a lot of information there. And I think this shape of a silicone mold is very nice. So why not make a beach coaster in the scallop shape silicone mold? so you can still see some parts of the first layer shining through. And I also don't add resin totally over the first layer. So this way you can create a nice depth. And on the edge of the clear resin, I'm adding white. And this is the Color Passion Top Cell White. There you can see it. And then with my heat gun, I blow that white into the clear. There you can see it. To hopefully create a nice wave. But also in this video you can see how I add gilding liquid, but also some real abalone shells. I think that will look nice. What I mentioned, I'm going to add gilding liquid, and this should resemble the sand of the beach, the darker parts of the sand. And I'm using the gilding liquid from Resin Pro, very nice gold color. So in some parts I'm adding the gilding liquid. And I can already see that it sparkles very nice, because I added the sparkle white into the two blue shades. But hopefully at the end of this video in a close-up you will also see it. Yeah, this takes a little bit of time. Yeah, this is the coaster holder, and I need to figure out how I can add those two legs, because there are no holes in the holder. So if someone knows, please tell me how I can add these coaster holder legs. Also some gilding liquid onto the coasters. There you can see it. And this is the first layer where I add the gilding liquid. So I will also be adding on the first layer some small shells and some abalone shells. So in total there are now two layers of resin in the silicon molds, and I will be adding one more resin layer in the mold, and the fourth resin layer I will be adding when I already have taken them out of the silicon mold. So now on top of that gilding liquid, I'm going to add really small shells. They are very nice. There you can see me try some on top of the gilding liquid. And these are really small pieces of abalone shell. I sell these in my Etsy shop, but then they are in between 5 and 30 millimeters. And they are very thin, so you can break them to small pieces very easy. So that's what I did. And now I'm going to add them on top of the gilding liquid. I think that will look nice. And the colors of these abalone shells will get more vibrant if you add resin on top of it, or a varnish or whatsoever. But then the colors of the abalone shell will get really nice. And they have all colors of the rainbow. But also at the end of this video, I'm going to show you a close-up of the shells, because they are really nice. And this is the first layer where I add those small shells. And that way I create the depth that I want. Again, some small pieces of abalone shells. So if you are interested in my abalone shells or mica pigments or chameleon mica pens, the link to my Etsy shop is in the description below this video. And some of my supplies are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. She also has the abalone shells and all the colors mica pigments. So the link to her Etsy shop is also below this video in the description. And with a small stick, I move those small shells to the place where I want them. But yes, still the gilding liquid is not totally dry. So before I'm going to add another resin layer, I need to wait at least 1 hour. So we are 1 hour later. Now I'm going to add a third resin layer, a clear resin layer, because I want those shells below the resin, because I want to have a flat coaster, and I need to fill the mold totally to the top using my heat gun to remove air bubbles. A little bit more resin, because the mold is not totally filled yet. Also the coasters, and I think they already look very nice. But I'm still not done. I will be adding one more resin layer, but that's after I take them out of the mold. Yeah, I never use a torch when I'm using a silicone mold. I almost mention it in every video when I use a silicone mold. If you use a torch, then you have a risk that the resin will stick to your silicone because the flame of the torch is very hot, and then the resin and the silicone will melt together. So I don't want to risk that, and that's why I'm using only a heat gun or an embossing tool to remove air bubbles. There you can see it. And these are the two legs for the coaster holder, in which I mentioned already that I don't know how to add these legs. So if someone knows it, please let me know in the comments below this video. So I'm done with the third layer. I will let this dry and then I will take them out of the mold. So we are 24 hours later. Now I can take the coasters and the coaster holder out of the mold. I don't have a problem with that. But I think they already look amazing, but I'm still not done what I already mentioned. I'm going to add another resin layer with a wave. So the coasters are out of the mold, and that is made with the Bouillant Rich Gold. It's a floating resin pigment, the gold. Also for the legs, and a Bombay Ink Blue. They already look amazing. And it has a great depth. They sparkle a lot, so that's what I like. Now we can take a closer look. So before I'm going to add a fourth resin layer, I will tape the back side, because this is the side how they can be used. The other side is not that pretty. So I will use masking tape, because then I can remove the resin drips much easier. There you can see the nice Bouillant Rich Gold next to the Bombay Ink Blue. So this is a close-up right after I took them out of the silicone molds. There you can see the small shells and the abalone shells. Very nice. I'm very pleased. Already a wave that I added. Hopefully you can see the sparkle. A closer look of the shells and the gilding liquid. Yeah, I'm very pleased. This is the coaster holder with all the abalone shells. I think it looks very pretty. So I'm going to add a fourth layer of resin. There you can see it. So what I already mentioned, I taped the other side of the coasters and the coaster holder, because then I can remove the resin drips much easier. Use my embossing tool to make the resin a little bit more liquid, but also to remove air bubbles. And I let it flow over the sides. make sure that I cover every part of the surface with resin. Adding more resin. And these coasters and coaster holder are totally flat. Now I can use a torch because I have removed them out of the silicone mold, and there you can see that I'm adding the white line because I want to add another wave. Use my heat gun to blow the white into the clear resin. I tilt the holder a little bit, then I use my torch. Now the coasters. I lift the coaster a little bit and then I use my heat gun to make the wave. And it's not that I'm looking for cells or lacing. I also like it without cells and lacing. What I want to create is a nice depth, and that's why I use several layers of resin to create that. Now the last two coasters. Again, a white line. And the last one. Now I'm going to tilt it a little bit to stretch the white and to create effects. Also with the coasters. So I'm almost done with this last layer. I will let it dry and then I will show you all the end result. So this is the end result. I have them outside in the daylight. I think they look amazing. I love those shells. And the depth is amazing. I love also the sparkle. There you can see already the small shells. The different waves. A little bit closer. There you can see it. Very nice. So let me know what you think of my resin beach coasters with real shells and abalone shells with nice waves and a sparkle in the ocean. I would really like to know what you think of my coasters and coaster holder. So all the information to the supplies I've used you can find below this video in the description. I want to thank you all for watching my video again. I hope you enjoyed it and hopefully I will see you all in my next video. Bye!